They're the jewels of East Tennessee, a place for us to cool off, play, and fish under the hot sun. But what's really in the water?
Pollution happens every day, all day long.
And some of that pollution could hurt you.
You could have some gastrointestinal effects, such as diarrhea.
Our story starts here at Beaver Creek in Karnes with Natalie Landry and her team from Knox County Stormwater Management.
And we're going to take a sample that will later be analyzed for bacteria.
They're testing for bacteria in the water before it makes its way downstream.
Beaver Creek's headwaters start way up in Gibbs, make its way through Halls, down through Powell, and into Karnes, and then finally flow down into Melton Hill Lake.
Beaver Creek is one of just hundreds of small streams feeding the lakes and rivers where we play. And as they wind their way through our communities, they bring pollutants along.
That's a major volume of water that's washing through there, and it's picking up everything along the way.
So what is in that water?
We probably have thousands, tens of thousands of chemicals in water.
State documents show pollutants and bacteria, such as E. coli, mercury, and PCBs, in Beaver Creek, First, Second, and Third Creek in Knoxville, Fort Loudoun Lake, Melton Hill, the list goes on. But the good news, experts say just swimming in the water likely won't get you sick.
You would have to swallow a lot of water many times before health effect would become apparent.
Dr. Frank Loeffler is a microbiologist at UT. He says it's safe to go in the water. The real danger is what you pull out of it. Some fish in our lakes have high levels of toxins.
We have toxic chemicals in the water, particularly, you know, associated with the sediment. And then fish like to eat food from the sediment.
Mercury and chemicals called PCBs rest on the bottom of the lakes. When we eat bottom feeder fish like catfish and largemouth bass from those lakes, we're also eating toxic chemicals.
But you may be exposed repeatedly over many years or decades to chemicals, and eventually that causes disease, like cancer.
And they can analyze that fish tissue and find out what that fish has consumed that may be potentially dangerous for you.
Kathy Hawes is the executive director of the Tennessee Clean Water Network. She says another concern is how often the government tests the waters to issue those warnings.
Some of our lakes aren't being tested by the government, but once every 2 years or 5 years, and that's not often enough.
She says that means some pollutants might slip through the cracks.
There's not cause for alarm, but there's great call for better awareness and action on some of these issues.